Hello friends, welcome to my channel Pharma Tutor. Myself Swapnil Mishra, and today we are going to study about gateway cloning. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and hit the like button. Thank you. First of all, we'll study what is cloning. It is the process of generating a genetically identical copy of a cell or an organism. It happens often in nature. For example, when a cell replicates itself asexually without any genetic alteration or recombination. In prokaryotic organisms such as bacteria, it creates genetically identical duplicates of themselves using binary fission or budding. It means when a bacteria replicates or produces its clone, it can produce its millions of copies within minutes or hours. So, bacteria is producing its clones using binary fission or budding. In eukaryotes such as humans, all the cells undergoes mitosis. But such as skin cells and cells lining GI tract called clones, the only exceptions are gametes, which undergoes meiosis and genetic recombination. So we can say skin cells and cells lining GI tract are clones in humans. Next is recombination cloning. It is a universal cloning technique which is based on the site-specific recombination, that is independent of the insert DNA sequence of interest, which differentiate this method from classical restriction enzyme-based cloning methods. The advantages of recombination cloning is it enables rapid and efficient parallel transfer of DNA inserts into multiple expression systems. Second, multiple entry clones of varied sequences can be simultaneously transferred into a single expression vector to make its specific kind. Now, we'll come to our main topic, gateway cloning. This system was invented and commercialized by Invitrogen Life Technologies since the late 1990s. It is a molecular biology method that enables researchers to efficiently transfer DNA fragments between plasmids using an appropriate set of recombination sequences. The gateway ATT sites and two proprietary enzyme mixes called as LR clonase and BP clonase. So this means, according to gateway cloning method, we can efficiently take our desired DNA fragment and insert into a plasmid, and with the help of different enzymes like LR clonase, BP clonase, we can produce our recombination sequence of desired interest. So in this figure we can see the basic structure of gateway cloning system, where we can take our desired gene of interest from different processes through PCR or our source library, gene library or gene synthesis or any other methods. And we can produce its entry clone, and further with the help of LR clonase and BP clonase, we can produce our recombination sequence. The advantages of gateway cloning systems are: it provides directional cloning, it maintains the reading frame, there is no restriction enzyme required, and there is no need of ligation required. This cloning system is a 1 hour room temperature reaction with more than 99% efficiency. There is no resequencing in this gateway cloning system. This method is compatible with automation, and it is a reversible reaction. So we can, after producing our desired DNA of interest, we can get our LR clonase and BP clonase back and use it further for next production. This method enables you to access virtually any expression system in just a few steps. It circumvents the roadblocks of traditional restriction enzyme cloning. There is no need for ligase, subcloning steps, or the hours spent to on-screen countless colonies. Gateway system relies on 5 sets of specific and non-crossing ATT sequences. The specificity is given by the 7 nucleotides of the core region. Basics of gateway cloning. 4 types. First, BP reaction to create in vitro gen gateway entry clone. Second, LR reaction to create a gateway expression clone. Third, 1-tube format to create gateway expression clone from a PCR product. Fourth, gateway vector conversion, where you can convert your favorite cloning vectors to gateway technology. BP reaction. What we will do, we will create a gateway entry clone with the help of ATTB Planck PCR product. It is an easy 1-hour reaction. What we will require, a 1.5 ml tube at room temperature and mix. We will take ATTB PCR product, donor vector, trace acetate buffer at pH 8 to 8 microliter. Thaw on ice the in vitro gen BP clonase to enzyme mixture for 2 minutes, vortexing the BP clonase enzyme mixture. Now, to step 1, we will add this clonase enzyme mixture and mix the reaction by vortexing briefly twice. Microcentrifuge them briefly. Now, return the extra BP clonase enzyme mixture to minus 20 to minus 80 degrees Celsius storage. Incubate the reaction at 25 degrees Celsius for 1 hour. Add 1 microliter of proteinase K solution to each sample to terminate the reaction and vortex briefly. Incubate the samples at 37 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. So, now after transformation, we'll get our expected result, that is entry clone. An efficient BP recombination reaction will produce more than 1500 colonies if the entire BP reaction is transformed and plated well. Here it is a diagrammatic representation of BP reaction. What we are taking is genomic DNA of desired interest, which we get through PCR product. What we are doing here, we are taking our desired DNA of interest and we are combining it with the donor vector. How we can combine both of them? We are taking the help of BP clonase enzyme mixture, and after combining this reaction mixture, what we are getting the final product is gateway entry clone for further reaction. LR reaction. It is similar to BP reaction, but the difference is between enzymes. There we were using BP clonase 2 enzyme, here we will use LR clonase enzyme. So we will take the product of first reaction, that is BP reaction. We will take our entry clone, destination vector, tris acetate buffer at pH 8 to 8 microliter, and we will take all these things in a 1.5 ml tube at a room temperature and we'll mix them. Thaw on ice the LR clonase enzyme mixture, repeat the same process as we did in BP reaction. What we'll get the final product is our expression clone. So after transformation, we will get the expected result, LR recombination reaction, which will produce more than 5000 colonies if the entire LR reaction is transformed and plated well. It is a diagrammatic representation of LR reaction, where you can see the first product of BP reaction, that is entry clone, combined with the P-Lenti CMV Puro destination vector. With the help of LR clonase enzyme, we are getting the final product, that is desired expression clone and extra biotoxic product. Third process, 1-tube format. If we are talking about this format in a simple process, it is basically performing all the reaction in a 1-tube, like BP reaction and LR reaction combinedly performed in a single tube is 1-tube format. Here we will take the same tube, we'll combine all the mixture that we have taken in BP reaction. First, we'll perform BP reaction in 1-tube, then we will add the destination vector in the same tube and perform the LR reaction with the help of LR clonase enzyme. After performing BP reaction and LR reaction, we will perform transformation and we will finally get our desired DNA of interest. This recombination reaction can be extended up to 18 hours. Now add 2 microliter of protease K solution, incubate at 37 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. After transformation, plate on LB plates containing the appropriate antibiotic to select for expression clones. We can also assess the efficiency of BP reaction following these steps. Gateway conversion. You can convert your favorite set of cloning vectors to gateway technology, which is a fairly straightforward protocol and will ultimately allows you to streamline your cloning and expression process. To convert your cloning vector to a gateway destination vector, you will choose the appropriate reading frame cassette to use depending on your needs. Linearize the vector you wish to convert with a restriction enzyme of choice. If you use a restriction enzyme that generates an overhang, you will need to blunt the ends. Remove the 5' phosphates from the vector using calf intestinal alkaline phosphatase. Ligate the reading frame cassettes into your vector using a T4 DNA ligase. Transform the ligation reaction into one shot. CCDB survival competent E. coli and select for transformants. Analyze the transformants. Advantages of gateway cloning. First, fast reaction. It is a 1 hour room temperature cloning reaction. Next, accurate results. Cloning reactions achieve more than 95% efficiency to deliver the clone you need. Third, versatile technology. Easily shuttles DNA material or insert from vector to vector. Fourth, streamlined protocol. No need of pre-sequencing. Use the same clone from target identification to validation. Thank you. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel at PharmaTutor.